when we recreated the images into 360-degree virtual reality, it became obvious very quickly that there's such a stark contrast between the virus-infected abnormal lung and the more healthy adjacent lung tissue. And it's such a contrast that you do not need an MD after your name to understand these images. This is something that the general public can take a look at and really start to comprehend how severe the amount of damage that this is causing to the lung tissue. The damage that we're seeing is not isolated to any one part of the lung. This is severe damage to both lungs diffusely.
So when you saw this, what did you feel? What was your first reaction?
My first reaction is, you know, as somebody who spends a lot of time educating the public about various conditions, as well as professionals, I wanted to get this message out and get this picture out to the public so that people who so far have not been heeding the warning of public health professionals can perhaps see these images and see the destruction that is being caused in the lungs and why these patients' lungs are failing to the point of needing a mechanical ventilator. Hopefully the public can see these images and really start to understand why this is so serious and how this virus really is not discriminating amongst various people, how it is really starting to affect people of all different ages. We do know that the majority of patients who are testing positive for the virus exhibit very minor or maybe even no symptoms, but approximately 20% of patients are exhibiting shortness of breath and more severe symptoms, and a percentage of those patients are the ones that we're now seeing in our intensive care units, and many of those patients are requiring mechanical respiration, requiring to be put on a machine to help them breathe.